The California Effect with Golston Dart and Kelly DeMarco.
Thank you so much for being with us tonight. We just heard from 10 more of the top Democratic candidates for president.
And now we want to hear from the voters and political experts, Robin Swanson, Dwight Williams, and Paul Mitchell about tonight's biggest takeaways and what we can expect from now until election night.
First, though, let's get reaction from the voters. We invited six men and women to watch tonight's debate and give us their take on how the candidates performed.
Let's check in with Brian Heap right now in Studio B. Brian.
Golston and Kelly, definitely a little bit more excitement in the room tonight than there was last night. A little more fireworks happening on the stage. And we'll start with Larry Verga. He's a retired manager. Larry, tell me your takeaway tonight. What was the initial reaction?
It went right off. You could see that last night they kind of agreed on everything. Tonight, they didn't seem to agree on anything at all. The one thing they did agree on, that they kept calling it a democracy when we live in a republic.
And I know that one really sticks with you, Larry.
Yeah, that gets me.
Okay, thanks, Larry. And we have Cynthia Moreno here. She's a voter from Sacramento. So, Cynthia, what was your big takeaway tonight?
Oh, I was just duly impressed with Kamala Harris. And I came in, you know, leaning towards other candidates, but I think she made me proud to be a Californian. She tackled the issues that are important to the state and the country, and I think that she really proved what it takes to beat Donald Trump.
Okay. Barry Axios, a community activist here in Sacramento, what'd you take away tonight?
Disappointed a little bit that the talk about reparations for African Americans wasn't more in depth. I thought Ms. Harris did a great job, great showing, but I would love to hear more about the police accountability throughout the country with police brutality against African Americans, as well as the reparation talk. Yeah. That conversation, I think, needs to be at the head of our conversation.
Okay, fair enough. And Clay Maynard, you're a retired Navy pilot. What'd you see tonight, Clay?
Well, I agree. I think there should have been more talk about reparations. And, you know, they didn't really say anything tonight that they haven't said before. But I do believe that Joe Biden may have lost a little ground, and maybe Kamala Harris picked up a little ground. And Bernie was Bernie. You know, everything's socialist.
Okay, fair enough. And Nicole Parra, you're also a voter from Sacramento. What'd you see tonight?
I think Kamala came out to play. I think this was a good opportunity. What I like to think about is the first date, all of us getting to kind of know each other, getting to know the candidates. And I agree with Barry. We definitely are interested to hearing issues like criminal justice reform. I also am very interested in talking about more on the college education. Not everyone wants to go to college. We need to make sure that the trades are represented, that we have folks who can afford to live in this country who don't go to college. And people are hurting, okay. And we need to have plans for that.
Okay, thanks, Nicole. And finally, we have Bassem Elkara here. He's a community activist. So what did you see tonight, Bassem?
Kamala came out swinging. I think she probably pulled a lot of supporters that were thinking about Joe Biden. I think her answer about day one, her first day on the job, what she's going to do coming out for DACA, the moral argument against Trump's immigration policies, I think was very powerful. And I think Bernie will maintain his supporters, but I think Kamala came out swinging today.
Yeah, very interesting takes. Kelly and Golston, you can hear that at least our panel senses maybe a little bit of a shift tonight.
Yeah, I think, you know, the viewers were engaged with what happened on stage tonight. Brian, thanks. We'll check back with you. And we want to welcome you back. We are continuing to break down tonight's Democratic debate, part two, with live reaction from voters and our political experts.
And our Brian Heap is with our panel of voters again. Brian.
Kelly and Golston, I was watching our panelists watch the debate tonight. And one thing I saw you do, Larry, you had some reaction when the topic of immigration came up and they were talking about children in cages.
Right. They pounded Trump heavily for locking children up and separating families and putting the children in these cages. Well, Joe Biden and Obama built those cages in 2014. They filled them up and they were full when Trump took over. And yet they're still blaming it on him. And Biden's up there like he's on the other side and he's responsible.
Okay. Thank you, Larry. Cynthia, I noticed that there were some things tonight that Kamala Harris said that really resonated with you. What did the most?
I think the fact that she was able to take on the Democratic candidates that were on stage, the fact that she was able to relate to her personal experiences as a prosecutor, as a senator, that she touched on her childhood, and she just became very relatable to me as a woman, but also like to the experiences that so many people people can relate to here in the state of California. She touched on issues that are important to people in the state that can relate to people in the country. She touched on gun violence, provided solutions. I think that she stole the show for me, definitely.
Okay. Barry, I know there was some talk tonight about social justice and about community policing in the communities. Did you hear enough of that, though?
Not at all. When we think about it, how we address it, the real reason why it's not been addressed and been dealt with in a way, we haven't had a federal way of dealing with it. We've been dealing with things in every state. California, we're dealing with AB 392, but there hasn't been a significant change because police officers are not going to jail for killing unarmed black African-American males or females. No one is going to jail. There's no accountability. There's no justice. There's no transparency. And there's no trust. The trust that was never there has to be trust that has to be built.
Okay. Thank you, Barry. And so, Clay, tonight, again, that word socialism with you, I know it's a bugaboo word for you.
Well, it seems to be a word for all the Democrat candidates. I think basically they all sort of favor socialist programs. And so, you know, the thing that really affected me first was the health care issue, and that was the first thing being discussed. And my mother and father didn't have health care insurance, neither did my grandfather and grandfather. But the difference between then and now is that then they didn't have the lawsuits and the regulations that we have now.
Okay.
So thank you, Brian.
Thank you, Clay. All right. And so, Nicole, again, Senator Kamala Harris, she really stood out to you tonight. What stood out the most about her?
You know, I think, as Cynthia said, she was able to personalize her story. And candidates, when they're able to take their experience and, you know, when she said, that girl was me, that was me. And she really kind of startled Biden. You can tell that. He was kind of taken back that it was her own personal experience. And one of the other statements about passing the torch, I got sick and tired of hearing that, because in order to move this country forward, we need people like Clay. We need our senior citizens. We need folks in the middle age. We need the young people to come together. Passing the torch is basically saying, hey, it's your turn. We need to all come together. And that's what I'm looking forward to as the debates progress, everyone working together.
Okay, that's a great point.
Senior citizen, thank you.
So, Americans.
Bossom, tonight I noticed that you actually had an applaud moment with something that Senator Harris said when she was talking about immigration.
I think when she talked about the crisis, why are folks coming to this country? Why is a mother taking her child and risking everything to come to this country? And so her and Senator Sanders addressed that. I think that was very important. And I think for Kamala, her stories, the rape victim, the undocumented rape victim that's afraid to call law enforcement because she's undocumented, the firefighter whose home is burning and he's fighting that fire, so when she addressed climate change, the climate crisis. So I think her and Bernie talking to the working class was also to the point, and he's going to maintain his base because he did that.
Okay, very good. So Kelly and Golson, you can hear, I think the opinions to me, in my opinion, feel a little bit stronger from our panelists tonight than they were last night, for sure.
Absolutely. Just like the second debate, I think a lot more explosive, a lot more opinionated.